I am looking forward to speaking with you. I'm looking forward to being engaged with you tonight. And I want to talk to you about a couple of things tonight. So we want to, if you are driving, definitely be cautious of your driving. But if you're in an area where you maybe can take some notes and sit back and listen to the conversation, let's do that. Tonight, I want to talk to you about the mental fitness. We've been talking about that for the last few weeks, and you know, some certain times of life that we go through situations, and it calls us to have some storms, have some difficult challenges, some things that happen in our life past, and so through those storms, we have to realize that we have to still be mentally fit to go through the process. And so I want to just challenge you tonight to get your mind ready for your next level. Last week we talked about that as well, and then I want to go into a little bit deeper about leaving that legacy. I have been speaking about the mental fitness and how it prepares us for our purpose and our destiny, but also it prepares us to leave that legacy for our children and our community and our family. And so what we need to focus on is just to understand what the purpose is, understand what our challenges are, and knowing that the storm that we're going through or the situation that we're going through, it's only temporary. We are only going through something that is not going to last forever. But the key thing is, as we go through that process, that we understand mentally how to negate or how to go through it and actually be better for it. And so many times that we go through a situation or a storm or something that has caused us to have some setbacks, we don't realize that sometimes those setbacks are for a good, a bigger comeback. And so what you have to realize is that as I'm going through this storm, I have to stay mentally alert to navigate my way through it. And you say, Latrina, what does that mean? What do you mean by staying mentally alert? I believe that, and this is my belief, is that as we go through a process of a situation, we have to speak life to ourselves. We have to engage ourselves in changing the environment that we may be in or the situation that's causing us to go through the process of a storm. Sometime it could be through a loss of a job or a loss of a loved one. And as we go through that process, we're seeing ourselves at the end of it. When you go through losing a job, you know that you have to gather yourself together and get your mind ready to go and look for a new job. And you have to go and say, well, maybe I should evaluate what I was doing and seeing if it's something that I might need to do different. If you have lost a loved one, you know, sometimes we lose loved ones, and sometimes through that storm of life, we realize that it may be something that's calling us to a higher level of awareness or doing something different that we've never done before, or even just evaluating our own personal health. You know, so certain storms that come in our life, it's not to keep us to the point where we don't realize or understand that it's temporary, but also to prepare us to move to our next level. And so I want to encourage you tonight. I want to give you some positive feedback, but also I want you to understand that the storm that you're going through, it's only temporary. It's only allowing you to get to that next level so you can say, I made it through my storm, because your storm is to guide you to your purpose. If you really evaluate a storm, then you will understand that it comes in waves. It comes and it goes. As that storm leaves, it actually leaves things in a place where certain things are becoming better. And so what I want to tell you tonight is that being mentally prepared, being mentally fit, allow you to girdle yourself or get yourself in mindset and check that you can do the things that you need to do through the process. And we have to understand that when we go through a mental fitness. A mental fitness is to exercise the mind and make the mind aware of what its faults may be, or aware of the things that it needs to do to increase the levels of its thinking, or its power, I should say. So when you go through a part where you understand that this is time to make me better, it's trying to equip me to do certain things differently, then you will start seeing yourself in a different way. I really believe that the more we exercise our brain, the more we reduce the stress, the more we stay hydrated and feed the brain the things we need, the more we'll be aware of how to navigate our way through storms or navigate our way through obstacles that comes in our life. And so if I'm constantly allowing my brain to keep me aware of certain things, then I won't become stagnated. I won't become to the point where I lose my ability to navigate through a storm or a situation in life, because I know that I have the power to change my outcome. That's the key, is that you have to understand that you have the power and the ability to change your outcome of that storm. You have the ability to look at your situation, understand your situation, and move forward. Once you get to that place in your life and you said, I see something different about myself, or I know I can do this differently than what I did before, then you're allowing your mind to grow and expand in areas that it has never done before. And so many times we cause ourselves not to really want to move into the area because of the discomfort, not feeling that we are capable of doing it, because it's going to challenge us and it's going to pull us to an area where we're not familiar or where we haven't done it before. And so many times it leads us to the place where we don't feel that we can do certain things because we haven't. And so if you look at, you know, someone that have wrote a book or have started a company, and they said, you interview them or you talk to them and they say, well, why did you do it? And some of them just let you know, I haven't did it before, and I had a feeling that I could do it. So you have to have enough trust in yourself and enough ability to think outside of the box that you can do whatever your mind is put to do. And so the thing is, you have to stay mentally engaged and mentally fit through that process. You have to understand that I'm capable of handling and doing whatever I need to do to get me through the process of life, get me through the areas of the storm. And what you have to realize is that this is a storm that I can manage. I can go through it. I can do what I need to do. And so as I tell you tonight is that you are in a process of changing your outcome, changing your way you think about yourself, changing the way you see yourself or how others see you, because you're looking at the mental fitness. Mental fitness doesn't always mean that I have to go and do so many rituals or so many different things. It's just changing the way you used to do things to make you better. Sleeping more, drinking more water, engaging in more activities. You know, we're so active in certain areas, but are you doing activities that's stimulating the brain? Are you doing activities that's causing you to think a little different? You know, some people play chess. Some people go do dance lessons. Some people go and do line dances. Something that's going to coordinate the brain or allow the right side and the left side of the brain to work together to build each other. And so we have to get to a place where it's okay. You know, I was telling someone, it's really when you go because I'm talking to a church setting and talking to an audience that can relate, it's just like when you go into praise the Lord and you're going into a praise, it's like when I go into a praise, I'm getting myself prepared to go into another mindset or another level. And when I go there, I'm releasing whatever stress, whatever was causing me to not be able to move forward, because I want God to take control. I want to be able to to do the things I need to do. And so what I'm saying tonight is that you have to be able to release the tension, release the areas of your mind that has caused you to feel that you can't move forward, that has caused you to think that you're not able or capable of doing the things that you need to do, because the power and the greatness is within the mind. And the Bible always talks about whatsoever man thinketh, so is he. So if I think on the goodness of Jesus, if I think on being prosperous, if I think on being healthy, if I think on these things, then I'm establishing it in my mindset that I'm ready for my change. I'm ready to do something different, because what you're doing is you're telling the mind it's time to do a shift. It's time to, you know, take control. It's time to move to another level. And that's one thing about when we know, it's like I used to tell some people, it's like when you know that you know that you know that it's supposed to be a change, you start moving towards that change. You start getting your mind, your household, your family, you start getting everyone ready for that big change because you know it's coming. And so with that storm that has maybe still be coming in your life, or you might be in the midst of a storm, or you might be in the midst of going out of the storm, or whatever it is, you have to realize that you know that it's not going to last always, that you have the power and the greatness within yourself to change your outcome, to start to gather yourself and start engaging into what it takes to make you better. So many times we listen to people that takes different medication, and this is one example that I can honestly say is that I can't take the same prescription that you may be able to take or you're taking, because everybody's body is different. And why are you saying that, Trina? You're probably saying, why are you talking about that? And we're supposed to be talking about mental fitness. Is that I'm trying to let you know that because my mindset is different, my body is going to react different. So if I'm allowing my mind to think different, my body will start to act and engage differently. So once you start to process it and understand your abilities to do things in your mindset, it changes the outcome or the environment that you're in right now. And so I have been doing a couple little researches on dementia and how an environment or the economic situation of a community could affect the outcome of why someone may have early onset of dementia, because your environment, you can become subject to it, or you can actually change it based off of you relocating out of it, or even making it better for yourself and others that is around it. But the key thing is that you have to make it to the point where you start to grow outside of it. When you start to grow outside of what is not the norm and start to build from that area, then there's avenues and doors that will open to you, but you have to first start by changing your mindset to see yourself different. See yourself in an area where you've never seen it before. Do some things that you never ever thought that you could do before, because the thing about changing your pattern or changing your way of your mindset, it allows you to see and grow in areas supernaturally, but also physically, that people will start to say, well, you're not the same. There's something different about you. You're not talking the same. You're not acting the same, because you start to change the perception of how you see yourself through the vision of your mindset. Your mindset is starting to tell yourself, oh, you can't do that anymore. And so I wanted to come on tonight and talk about leaving a legacy as well, because I briefly talked about it in my Facebook Live yesterday, and I briefly talked about it last week, and how we can leave a legacy for our family in the midst of a storm. The reason why I know you can do it, and I know that people have done it, is because they did not let, or they did not get to the point where they gravitated more towards the storm, but they seen what they needed to do differently. And so as you start to look at what you need to do differently, start to engage or start to wonder, what can I do to leave an inheritance or a legacy for my children or my family or my community that they can see that I made a difference, I made an impact. Start to see yourself and think on those things and start moving towards that thing. You know, there's a few things that I want to make sure that you understand is that we are people that have the ability to change the outcome of our culture, of our communities. But we, if we don't do it and start seeing ourselves or thinking ourselves to do it, then we will never be able to do it. We'll never do it because we can't see past what our past is. We can't see past what someone may have said about us. We can't see past that. So if you can't see past it, you can't move forward. You have to be able to relinquish or let go of your past, your unforgiveness, the things that was holding you back. You have to be able to say, I won't let that distract me or deter me from going forward because I know I have greater powers. I got greater abilities to do the things I need to do. And so start to exercise your mind by journaling more, drawing. Some people draw. Some people play music. Start to see yourself doing a little bit more things differently than what you have been. And if you had been, increase it. You know, I do word puzzles. I do my reading. And so as I do these things, I'm constantly trying to figure out ways to increase my process, increase the way I do things, look at things a little different, because if I start to see it different, I can operate in it differently. So those are things that I wanted to talk to you about tonight is that how do I leave a legacy in the midst of my storm? Leaving a legacy is that I was telling someone that, you know, Dr. Martin Luther King, he left a legacy. Rosa Parks, she left a legacy. Harriet Tubman, that they left legacies. These are people that left something, an impact on our country, our nation. And so what is it in you that we're needing from you for you to leave your legacy? You have to be able to say, I made a difference. I changed the way I thought. I changed how I seen myself, because so many times people will see you and try to keep you from going forward. But you have to know that you have a calling to do something greater. You have the calling to do something mighty and powerful. And so the thing about it is, as you grow, as you start to exercise your mind, reading, eating the proper foods, I have updated my website. Please go onto my website, which is www.neuropathictrainers.com, and that's NEUROPATHIC trainers.com. Please go to that website, sign up for our quarterly blog, I should say newsletter, and I'm going to be talking a little bit more about the mental fitness. I'm going to be talking to you a little bit more about how to engage in conversation with your loved ones, because sometimes it's what we say can be hurtful. It's how we say it can hurt other people. And so leaving it to the point where we are able to reproduce by based off of what we're saying. You're saying, well, what do you mean by that, Trina? You want to be able to reap benefits of a good harvest. You want to be able to sow seeds of happiness and reap the reward of joy. You want to be able to sow seeds of repentance and know that you're an overcomer. So the thing about it is you have to be able to see yourself in an area that you have never seen yourself. And so that's what this is going to be about, is that seeing yourself somewhere that you could see a legacy that you left for your children, opening up a gift shop or opening up a store, doing books, whatever it takes. You know, you heard, this is my personal intake, that you have heard people say, well, you know, they didn't leave anything for their children, or they didn't do very much. They were here and they didn't they didn't make a difference in society, and you thought that they would be change agents. You thought that they would come in and change the world. I'm here to tell you, you're a change agent. You're a person that are supposed to make a difference. You're the person that's supposed to make the difference in your family, in your community, and most of all, with your loved ones. Because if you can change your mindset of where you're at and what you've done, you can move forward in life without disregards or regrets or any kind of form of, I didn't do enough, because you allow the things that you went through to build you to your next level. And so those are some of the things that I wanted to talk to you about tonight. I wanted to make sure that you understood where you were at, what this means by leaving a legacy. How do I leave a legacy without, you know, going through the process of understanding myself? You know, sometimes we don't really know what we're looking for, but we know God has a plan. And so my thing tonight is, you're at a place where it's time for you to change your outcome, change the way you see yourself, change the way you look at yourself, changing the things that you know that is not good for you. You know, I was in a meeting earlier today, and the young lady, she said, you know, and once a person get out of their environment, it's more healthy for them to grow in a mindset. Because if I'm staying in an area where or in a relationship and it's not allowing me to grow mentally, it's not allowing you to grow mentally, you cannot walk in your purpose. You will not be able to leave a legacy, because you have to get to a place where you are ready. Excuse me, you're ready to move to the next level. You're looking at what that next level is, because I can't stay in an area that's not conducive for my growth process. You can't stay somewhere and you don't see yourself moving forward. You're just sitting there. You're just at, you know, and I hate to say this, but sometimes we get into a church setting or into a but members of a church, and you're not growing in the areas that you know that you should be growing, and you saying, God, it's got to be something. But in your gut, you know, in your gut, you know that there's something more, there's something better, but you can't put your finger on it. You can't kind of tap into it, but you know that there's something different that you need to do, or something different that you're supposed to be doing. And so with mental fitness allow you to evaluate every area of your mind as well as your environment or and your, you know, what you're around. Because once you start to see yourself differently and do things differently, your mind will start to expand in areas that it never thought to go to. You know, I was telling somebody, you know, I knew I wanted to write a book. I knew I wanted to open up my business again. I knew I wanted to relocate. I know that I wanted to do these things. And so as I started to engage myself or do some things, I started to see myself doing that, because I started to put my mind in an area to allow me to expand it. I started to make conversation about the book. I started to do research on the book. And then, so even if it's not a book, it could be the business. You want to open a business. Have you did the research? After you start doing the research, have you looked for the name? You know, those things is what triggers your mind to grow, because the more you start to feed the mind to get to that place of moving forward, then you start to change your environment. You start to see yourself doing things different than what you did 3 months or a year ago, because you're not in that same space. And that's the beauty of mental fitness. It allows you to grow and not be in the same headspace, so to say, as you're growing and outside of your physical being. And so when you start to challenge your mind, it starts to challenge your environment. It starts to challenge you to see yourself different. And so I want to encourage you tonight to start to challenge your thought process. Start to challenge how you see yourself. Do the physical exercises. Do the mental exercises, because like I've always said, you if you want to be better physically, you have to start being better mentally. If you want to be better physically, you have to start doing better mentally. And you say, well, how do I do that? What do you mean by that? If you start to think those things, if you start to move in those directions mindset-wise, then physically all the things will be done after that. And I'm a true believer that if I'm thinking on those things, if I set my mind towards it, then my body will eventually move in that direction. The things that I need, the people that I need to come in contact with, the doors that I need to open, that need to be open for me, they will automatically start to open up because I'm physically, mentally putting myself in that position so I can physically start to move in it. Because I have to start educating myself on certain things. And that's what I want to talk to you about is how do I do that? Leaving a legacy. What are you leaving for your children? What are you leaving for your community? What are you doing to allow yourself not to just be here to take up space? And I'm not saying space in general, but breathing air and not being functional or being a person of moving into your purpose because you're not doing what you're created to do. And as you've been able to move forward in your ability to be creative and got the things God has called you to, then you're able to leave the legacy. And so that is why it's important for you to challenge yourself. Challenge yourself mentally of what you need to do. There's things that I will be talking about in the next few weeks. I will have a guest speaker on next week. I think it's next week. I have a guest that will come on, and we're talking about mental fitness as well as physical fitness from a different cultural aspect and how it works for different cultures across the United States as well as the country. You know, how do you get yourself from that level? And how do you stay in tune? And so those are the things that we want to talk about. But I want to hear from the audience. I want to hear from you. I know we're on a radio station, but I have information that you can reach out to me, not only through GMAP1, do their broadcast, but also you can reach out to me because I want to start doing some surveys of what people are looking for and what they're trying to accomplish through the mental fitness, you know, because so many times we see ourselves moving in a direction, but we are not mentally capable because we're not allowing ourselves to grow and do the things we need to do. And so I want to challenge you to start to do the exercises. I I have started working on my book, and it's the other book that I have is called 10 Keys to Mental Fitness. 10 Keys to Mental Fitness. And you're saying, what is that? I'm telling you how to do a daily activities that will allow you to grow mentally, daily activities that will allow your brain to function, daily activities that will get you to a place where you're saying, I can accomplish some things that I didn't think I can accomplish because I'm feeding my brain. I'm expanding my brain thoughts. I'm doing things different than what I used to do because I'm not in the same headspace. I'm not in the same area that I needed to be in. And so my 10 keys to mental fitness. First thing in the morning, I want to give these things to you, and this is on a daily activity. This is something you can do in your 10 steps in a day. This is basically 10 steps in a day. So when you first get up in the morning, and this is the legacy that I'm talking about as well. I want to make sure that I give you the keys. But the first thing when you get up in the morning, and I talk about the peppermint oil. Take the peppermint oil and put 2 drops in your hand and rub your hands together and do the 10 deep breaths. as you do 10 deep breaths, you're allowing the brain, the blood to flow to the brain properly, and you're allowing the brain to get the proper oxygen that it needs throughout the day. And so taking that is step one. That is step one, key number one. First thing in the morning, before your feet hit the ground, reach beside your nightstand or wherever you in your bathroom or wherever you have it. Make sure you grab your peppermint oil. Grab the peppermint oil, put two drops in your hands, rub it together, and take 10 deep breaths, which will allow you to get into your prayer time as well as your meditation. But it also, the key thing it does, it wakes the brain up and allows the blood to start flowing correctly. This is something, this is part of my legacy. This is part of what I'm leaving for people to understand. I'm leaving this so that people would know their next level. And so that's what I want to leave for you is that number one is to go in and start with your peppermint. Number two is as you're doing your peppermint, I want you to get into that prayer mode. I want you to go into your meditation, going into that morning, I thank you, Jesus. I thank you, God, for another day. Going into that because your peppermint is waking you up, but you, as you wake up, you're allowing yourself to communicate and to go in communion with God. So that's number two. So those are the first steps. And you say, well, it seemed like it might be out of order for you. For some people, it might seem like it's out of order because you're supposed to pray first. But I'm telling you, wake your brain up. Start the blood to flow. Allow the blood to get to the point of flowing first. Then you pray. Then you going into prayer because you want the blood to flow because, one, his blood flew. His blood was flowing through us. So we want blood first, then we're going to pray. So we want to go from taking the peppermint oil first, then go into prayer and meditation. Then I want you to get an 8-ounce glass of water and drink it. You want to purify and hydrate your body after you went through your prayer time. So that's number three. Number four is that I want you to go in and get your smoothie. I have started to work on my smoothie that I'm having, but I also want to, the smoothie that I would be putting on the market, but I also want you to get something to start to feed the brain. I talk about drinking dark coffee. I talk about green tea, getting an avocado. Drinking a smoothie with some beets in it, certain things that's going to feed the brain, eating a boiled egg. So that's step number four. Step number three, like I said, I'm sorry, five will be some form of coffee or something like that. But also step number five, which is really, really important, is to not allow yourself to engage with negative people, negative thoughts. This is a daily walk. Now, this is your daily activity that your 10 steps for 10 keys to mental fitness. And this book will be published soon. And so in that 10th step number five is to not be around people that are negative, that are giving you a poor advice. Negative thoughts, start to encourage yourself. If you have to listen to speakers that's going to encourage you, you have to listen to motivated speaking or whatever it is, detox yourself from anything that's negative. Number six, I want you to start to increase your reading levels, increase your knowledge. Even if you're starting a book, increase your knowledge on the research that you need for your book. Increase the knowledge on what's going on around you in your environment. You know, how the things are being done in regards of your health care. Whatever it is that's going to help you, I want you to read up on it. That's half an hour to an hour, half an hour to an hour every day. Read upon something that's going to benefit you. That's all I'm asking. That's all you need. And then number seven And this is going to take some collaboration from your doctor. But I want you to start to deal with your vitamins and herbs. And I want you to talk to your doctor about alternative medication. Talk to your doctor about alternative ways of taking care of your health. That's number 7. Number 8 is exercise. Number 8, I want you to go for your 30-minute walk, power walk. And this is 10 keys to a daily. This is a daily mental fitness exercises, daily mental keys, 10 keys to mental fitness on a daily basis. You do this, these things that I'm telling you, you will be completely a different person within 30 days, completely a different person within 30 days. Guarantee it. So number 8 is exercise. Number 9 is body detox, stress relief, that whatever it takes to do a body detox. Some people drink teas. Some people take certain medication, certain supplements to detox their body. Some people do drinking certain liquids or certain things that detox your body, but I do something called Omega 7. And so you can take an Omega 7, Mega 07, and that I actually will post that on my website. And so that actually is a detox that you can do for 10 days, and your body will start to detox itself from any unclean or unhealthy toxins from food. So you want to detox your body. Number 10, which is going to allow you to get to that place. When you get ready to go back to sleep that night, you want to make sure you get plenty of rest. Number 10 is rest. You want to get enough sleep throughout your night that will allow your body to rejuvenate itself and allow the blood to constantly flow so you can do the same thing over the next day. Those are my 10 keys to mental fitness. That book will be coming out. That book will be released within, I'm trying to do it a little quicker than normal, but it will be either an ebook or either it will be a handbook that you can pretty much take and put some notes in it as well. But it's going to be a quick synopsis of how to do a mental fitness on a daily basis. On a daily basis. So everything that I just gave you is something you do on a daily basis. So these things, if you utilize it, then it will allow you to get through your storm, but also it will allow to focus on what is your purpose to leave you a legacy. So this is what I want to leave with you tonight. And I know my time, I don't want to run out of my time, but I want to go over these things with you one more time and look for the book, 10 Keys to Mental Fitness. 10 Keys to Mental Fitness. And number 1 is taking your peppermint oil. Number 2, prayer and meditation. Number 3 is staying hydrated, drinking plenty of water. Number 4 is eating your smoothie, drinking coffee in the morning or some kind of green tea, and having the right food throughout the day. I will have a meal plan as well in that, in those step number 4. Number 5, no negative people or thoughts. No negative people or thoughts. That's your number 5. That means wherever I'm going throughout that day, I'm going to relinquish myself from any negative thoughts about how I feel about myself or how I feel about other people. I'm going to relinquish myself from people that is negative. I'm going to get away from that. That is one of your daily activities that you have to stay with. Number 6 is that I'm going to increase my reading knowledge of what I'm trying to do or accomplish. I'm going to increase more of my reading on what I need to do in regards to my health and my well-being. I'm going to talk to my doctor about my medication. I'm going to increase myself about my awareness of who I am. That's your number 6. Number 7 is you're going to talk to your doctor about alternative medicine, things that you can do to allow you to get away or from pharmaceutical products, and also getting into a holistic type of situation where you see yourself growing mentally as well as physically in your body. So though that's number seven. Number eight is exercising. Getting and doing your 30-minute walk, power walk, doing some jumping jacks, whatever type of exercise that you need, cardio, whatever you need to do within a 30 to 45-minute gap. We have 24 hours in a day. A lot of us work 8 to 10 hours a day. After you get it from the 8 to 10 hours a day, I'm telling you, I didn't put anything about going and watching TV. I didn't put anything about all these other activities. I'm telling you, these are things that you can do that will allow your body to grow, allow your mind to grow. And so 8 is exercising, and you just need 35 to 45 minutes a day. Power walk, do some cardio, do some weight strength training, whatever it is to get your mind, letting the blood flow and getting the brain to grow. And number 9 is body detox, how to take the toxins from the food that you have been eating, take and relieve it through the waistline of taking it out up through your stool. And just detoxing, drinking detox tea, going and, like I said, getting the Omega 07. And so that way you can start to get rid of some of the toxins in your body. Look at what you need, because everyone's body is different. Some people's digestive system is different, and they can't use harsh type medication to do a detox. So if it means going and doing a smoothie that has some certain foods in it or certain fibers or certain things that will allow you to detox your body, do that. And number 10, rest, rest, rest. Sleep, sleep, sleep. The more I sleep, my 8, and some people only get 6 to 8 hours, but if I try to get a little over 8 hours, then you're allowing your body to rejuvenate the brain cells. You're allowing yourself to become that super person for the next morning. You're getting your body the proper rest that it needs. Those are my 10 keys to mental fitness. That book I am working on, I am looking to have it out as soon as possible. But that's something that you can see, something that you can have. There's going to be some pages in it that you can do some journaling from what your daily activity was or whatever you're doing. So that way you can have some notes to put some things in to keep you on track. So that is something that I think that would be beneficial. And I'm so honored to be on the show, the broadcast tonight. Like I said, I wanted to make sure I came on live. I wanted to make sure that I leave you something. This is part of my legacy. This is part of my mental fitness, is to leave something for you. And so as I grow, I want you to grow. As we go to the next level, I want us to go together. And so this will expand our process and our thought process of what it takes for us to get to our next level. I'm walking in our purpose, walking in your destiny, walking in what God has called you to do. And so that's the 10 keys to mental fitness. Please go to my website again, www.neuropathictrainers.com. And that's N-E-U-R-O-Pathic, P-A-T-H-I-C, trainers.com. Yeah, a little stumbled myself here. But I want to make sure you go to the website and get the information, because there will be some information in regards of the different oils and why we should use certain oils, such as cannabis oil, which is the CBD oil, peppermint oil, lavender. And so those things, cinnamon, there is a cinnamon oil that we're working on as well. Those things will be on the website shortly as well. But we want to make sure that you understand that those are the things that we need to utilize to take us to our next level, so we can be able to let our body heal from the inside out. allowing the body to go and do the things we need to do. I'm a big fan and believer of using oils to put in my diffuser at night before I go to bed. I cleanse my air, and I did mention rest. And so in using that, I will, in the chapter that we talked about rest, I will be talking about having a diffuser on before you go to bed to allow the air to be purified and cleansed, so that way you can breathe clean air as you start to dream, so or go to sleep. So those are some of the things that I wanted to leave with you tonight. Again, please go to my website, go to www.neuropathictrainers.com for any speaking engagement or to know more about my Trina Brown Speak page. Please go there at www.TrinaBrownSpeaks.com in regards of any up-and-coming engagements, anything that you can be getting involved in. I will be doing some speaking in the Maryland, Virginia area within the next 90 days. So I definitely want to make sure that we you have that information as well. But I definitely wanted to let you know tonight that as you go through a storm, remember that the storm is only temporary. It's only there to let you see that there's something greater on the outcome of it, and your greater part of it is to allow you to walk into your purpose. As you walk into your purpose, you're walking into your greatness, and your greatness and your is leading to your legacy. Make sure you understand that your legacy is tied to your purpose. Know that your legacy is tied to your purpose. And so why would I say that? Because as you start to change your mindset and the environment that you're in and the things that you're doing, you will start to understand your purpose even the more. You'll understand why God has created you to be so unique, why you're created to be that special person, because you have assignment to leave a legacy like no other. Not only did Dr. Martin Luther King and Rosa Parks and all those have a legacy, but they were on a special assignment. What is your assignment to make you great? What is your assignment that's going to cause you to live in that place that you never seen yourself? What is that assignment about you tonight? What is that thing that's been tugging at you and you can't think, you can't seem to shake it, and every time you try to shake it, it keeps coming back, because that's part of your purpose. That thing that's in your mind and in your heart that constantly go back and forth between your mind and your heart, and you're trying to figure out how to do it, and God has said, and just trust me through the process. Trust him through the process of this storm. Trust them through the process of the situation, understanding that as you go through the process, you're moving into a better area. You're moving into that area that's a little different, that area that is causing you to see some things differently. And so I just want to encourage you tonight. I want to let you know that you have the ability to change your environment as you allow yourself to change your mindset. Change your mindset so you can walk into your purpose. As you walk into your purpose, you're walking into your legacy. Leave a legacy for your community. Let people know that you were here. Let people understand that you're here to make a difference. You're here to make an impact in our culture, in our community, and especially in our gospel community. You're here to do things like never before. And so thank you again for coming on and listening to Neuropathic Trainers Broadcast. Thank you for coming on and listening to Trina Brown Speak. It is my pleasure and honor to be a host and a servant unto you, because I know as we change our environment and as we change our mindset, God is calling us to walk into our purpose. And I'm guaranteeing you that as you do that, you're going to start leaving a legacy for your family. Again, thank you for coming on. I want to say a quick prayer in closing and go into for the next broadcast. Thank you, Father God, for coming and speaking onto our hearts tonight. God, we thank you for the opportunity to be able to host the show, God. We thank you for all those listeners, Father God. I ask you that you would touch them as they go, as they come forth, Father God, and I ask you that you would go to the north, east, south, and west and bring your people to a place of understanding their purpose, God. Bring them to the place of understanding what they're called to do, Father God. As we continue to challenge our mind to allow us to be the person that you have called us to be, our power and our greatness would allow it that is within us, that you allow to be within us, that we'll start to see ourselves different every day. We'll start to see ourselves being who you've called us to be. Father God, and we just thank you for tonight, God. We thank you for Pastor Kevin, and we thank you for his family. God, we ask that you will continue to bless this audience, continue to bless the station, Father God. Continue to increase, Father God. Send an increase like never before, Father God. We thank you for the mindset. We thank you for neuropathic trainers broadcast. We thank you for how the doors are going to be opening for us to bring other people on, that we can be able to share information to empower our communities, our churches, our neighborhoods, Father God, that people will see their mindset. They will understand what this means to be in a perfect peace, Father God, keeping our mind in perfect peace as we stay on you, Father God, as we keep it stayed on you, Father God. And Father God, keeping our mind in perfect peace, that's something that some people can't say they do. But God, we thank you for perfect peace. We thank you for it, Father God, in the name of Jesus, God. We just come to say thank you tonight, God. We ask that you would touch the broadcast as other people come on, Father God, as we continue to grow. Father God, we ask that you continue to grow with us, Father God. Father God, we thank you in Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen. We